In this video, we're going to take a look at making a histogram in your calculator from data that you've already entered. So if you didn't do the video already on how to enter data, this is the data that I'm going to be working with right here. So go ahead and pause on this screen for a second and go ahead and enter all of that data into your calculator so that we can use that data to create a histogram from. Now, when you're making your histogram in your calculator, it is important that you've already made a frequency table because some of the information from the frequency table we will actually need to create the histogram. So for this set of data that we're dealing with right here, let's say that we wanted to use five classes. So we would need, you know, class limits, class boundaries, and we would also need to know the class width. That's actually all you need to know to be able to make a histogram in your calculator is class width, limits, and boundaries. So our class width, we take the maximum data value, which in this case is 13, minus the minimum data value, which was 1, and divide that by the desired number of classes, which say we were going to do 5 classes. So that gives us 2.4, which we then round up to 3 for our class width. So then with our class limits, we start at the lowest data point of 1. Next class will start at 4 because we're adding on 3 there. Add on 3 again, 7, then 10 and 13, which means that this first class goes from 1 to 3, 4 to 6, 7 to 9, 10 to 12, 13 to 15. And all you really need to know in order to make a histogram in your calculator from your class boundaries is the lowest class boundary, which if our lowest class limit was 1, our lowest class boundary would be 0.5. You also need to know the highest class boundary, which if our highest class limit was 15, our highest class boundary would be 15.5. These three things are the only three things that you need to make a histogram in your calculator. So you need to have put this data into a list, and then what you do once your data are put into the calculator is press second Y equals, which will take you to your stat plot menu. You have three plots to choose from, and you want to make sure that only one of them is turned on at a time. You can see here my first one is on, the other two are off. I'm going to press enter to select plot one. Make sure that the word on is highlighted rather than off. Under type, if we're making a histogram, you want to use the down arrow key to drop down to type, and then the right arrow key twice to navigate over to the histogram icon and press enter to select it. So now we'll be making a histogram. Then for X list, you need to use the list in which your data are stored. Mine are in list 1, so that's fine. And in general, frequency should be set to 1, so that's also fine. Now, at this point, if you just wanted to get a picture of a histogram, you can actually press zoom and the number 9, and your calculator will auto-size your window to give you a histogram. That being said, because the back of the book, if you want to check your answer, has forced our hand in terms of how many classes to use, if I use zoom 9, it lets the calculator pick the number of classes, and chances are it won't pick the same number of classes as our textbook. So I will need to manually adjust the window. To do that, press the window button. And this is where you need to know some information from your frequency table. You want to set your X min to your lowest class boundary, which was 0.5. So we'll set that to 0.5. Your X max needs to be set to your highest class boundary, which was 15.5. Your X scale should be set to your class width, which in this case was 3. Your Y min should be set to 0. And then your Y max should be set to a little higher than whatever your highest frequency was from your frequency table. Since I didn't actually make the entire frequency table here, I don't know what my highest frequency was. I'm just going to use 10 as a guess. If that's not high enough, we'll come back and adjust it. And then your Y scale here, since we're going from 0 to 10 on the Y axis, doing that in increments of 1 would be fine. If I'm going from 0 to 500, I might want to use increments of 100, for example. So just use something in Y scale that makes sense. And then when you have your window all set up, press graph. Oh, and here, this is actually sort of what I was hoping would happen. You'll notice that I'm cutting off the top of a couple of bars here. What that means is I'm not going high enough on my Y axis. So I can go back into window and my Y max needs to be something higher than 10. Maybe 15 will work. We'll see. So I'm going to change that to 15. And press graph again. Nope, still not high enough. Look at that, it's still cutting off one of my bars. Whoops. So I'll press window. Now maybe I'll do 20. And maybe now I'm going to change my Y scale to going up in increments of 2. Oh, there we go. Perfect. So now it's not cutting off the top of that bar. So here's my histogram. You can see it has the 5 classes that we wanted. I can see it's a nice unimodal, somewhat symmetric, maybe slightly skewed right distribution. What you don't get in this picture is you don't get to see what the increments along the axis are. But you can fix that by pressing the trace key. It will put a blinking cursor at the top of the first bar. It tells you that bar goes from 5 to 3.5. And it also says that n equals 3. So in that first category from 0.5 to 3.5, we had 3 pieces of data. If you press your right arrow key, it will bring the blinking cursor to the top of the next bar. That bar represents the category from 3.5 to 6.5, and we had 15 pieces of data in there. In the next category, that's 6.5 to 9.5, we had 17 pieces of data, and so on and so forth. I can look at each different class. If you want to clear all that information from your screen, you can just press graph again. And that's how to create a histogram on your calculator.